Good morning and welcome to our Senior College prize giving and graduation ceremony. But before we get started into that, we're just going to have the national anthem. And first up, we're going to go straight into our senior college subject prizes. Here we have one prize per subject, and that can be won by either a year 12 or a year 13 student. And teachers have chosen students based on either outstanding effort, attainment, or improvement.
Our senior college subject prizes are as follows. For business studies, for attainment, the award winner is Nicole Mazira. For chemistry, for effort and progress, Chikondi Maliki. For economics, for effort, the award goes to Zanele Munjanja. For information technology, for attainment, Chisha Sikazwe. For physics, for attainment and effort, the award goes to Abhishek Shanguman. Travel and tourism, for attainment, Nabila Lunat. Biology and mathematics, biology, effort and attainment, mathematics for progress, Teresa Nell. The English Language Award and Geography, English for Effort and Attainment, Geography for Attainment go to Tabea Kredolfa. For History, Literature, Physical Education and Psychology, History for Effort and Attainment, Literature for Attainment, PE for Effort and Psychology for Attainment, the award winner is Elizabeth Hoskins. And our Grit Award this year goes to Solomon Baker.
During the course of this year, we've had a number of students who have completed 10 years at Baobab College, and we're now going to recognise them for this significant achievement.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Hoskins. So as the school year draws to a close, we have three students in Senior College who have completed 10 years of being Baobab students. So we have in Year 12, Mitali Chicha, and in Year 13, Lusame Kamumba, and Zanele Munjanja. Congratulations, guys, obviously for Lusamaker and Zanele, it brings your school career to an end. Mitali, you've got one more year, you complete 11 years at the end of next academic year. Well done, guys. And now we're gonna have some music, and we're going to listen to Le Petit en Blanc by Jacques Hilbert, performed by Elizabeth Hoskins. Thank you. And at this stage, I'd now like to hand over to Mrs. Noble, who is going to give her address and also announce the winner of this year's Principal's Award.
For our Year 13s, and indeed some of our Year 12s, today marks the end of your formal time at Baobab College and the beginning of a new chapter in your lives. For others in Year 12, however, we look forward to welcoming you back to school in Year 13 in August. For those of you who are leaving us now, we are so glad that you joined the Baobab family, and we have been privileged to have you with us. It has been my absolute pleasure to have travelled with you over these last 2 years. Regardless of when your journey began, I want you to know that your teachers, your parents, and I are all exceedingly proud of you. As much as we are sure that you have learned so much in your lessons and in all your activities throughout your time here, we want you to know how much you've also taught us, individually and collectively. Mostly this year, you have taught us what you really value, and that is being together. As our senior college students, you have been wonderful. You have embraced the challenges, not only those normally inherent to the sixth form, but all the new challenges that this last year has brought. You've shown your capacity to keep learning, to support each other, and to share laughter. You've brought joy into many people's lives. You've shown a deep care for one another and have looked after each other through these days. You've kept in touch and you've encouraged each other. You've shown a willingness to find a way forward when first our plans were not possible. I know that this enormous resilience and deep awareness of others will stand you in good stead for your futures. So as we end this year, remember how proud we all are of you, and that you each have incredible capacity and gifts, and that the world is already a better place because your presence and your contributions. Our school magazine this year focuses on words of wisdom from all of our staff. I'd like to share with you some of my words. Your life is now. Seize it and make it amazing. It's up to you and no one else. Discover your passion and purpose in life and pursue it relentlessly. Discover that a sense of duty to community and others means far more than personal financial gain. Be honest at all times, generous and kind to others. Don't hold grudges. Life is too short. Just move on. Be the first one to reach out when you've argued with someone. Take that initial step. Learn to forgive as you would want to be forgiven by others. Surround yourself with love, laughter, and truth. And finally, make a difference. Be brave and stand out from the crowd. I sincerely wish you all well as you take your steps along life's paths. I wish you all a wonderful holiday, and please do come back and visit Baobab if you're leaving us for the last time. This year's Principal Award is given to a student who has risen above and beyond his personal circumstances and achieved what we would have all thought impossible just a few years ago. As I read through the citation and the description, I wonder if you can guess who it's referring to. This student has been at Baobab since 2017, when he started in Year 10. He's been a full-time boarder since that time with his family living in Lesotho. When COVID struck in March 2020, he immediately returned home and he has been online with us until he came back into school to write his examinations in May 2021. That is a remarkable 13 months of remote learning and support. During this time, he joined all classes online, even having to write his mock examination over Google Classrooms invigilated by Mr. Turner. He's persevered and shown real grit, tenacity, and determination throughout this time. This was especially hard for him when his friends were able to come back to school, but he wasn't. He never gave up, and that is why he is truly a worthy recipient of the Principal's Award for 2020-2021. I have the greatest pleasure in awarding the Principal Award for 2020-21 to Alinani Membe. It's very fitting that Alinani has this trophy actually online as he watches us now from his home in Lesotho. He plans to go to Canada to study biomedical research next year, and we wish him all the very best. I'd also like to thank Mr. Turner, all of his teachers and his family who supported him over this last year. Very well done, Alinani.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Noble. And now we're going to move on to the second part of our ceremony this morning, the graduation for our Year 13 students. In total, we have 24 students graduating this morning. And we're going to start in order of those who joined us most recently, going all the way down to those who have been with us for a very, very long time.
Chikondi Maliki, who joined us in November 2019. She's going on to do a medical-based degree in the UK, not entirely sure which location yet. Nicole Mazira, who also joined us in November 19, is also planning on going to the UK to study economics and finance. Tapfuma Monrove, who joined us in the August of 2019, he's going to study politics, philosophy, and economics at the University of Birmingham. Joshua Dupreez, again joining us in August 2019, he's going to have a gap year, and then he's planning to going off to either Canada, Spain, Holland, or South Africa, and hasn't yet quite decided quite what he's going to study, it seems. Jenna Slabbert joined us in November 2018. She's off to the UK. She wants to study forensic psychology at Nottingham Trent University. Charity Tembo joined us 2017, and she's also planning on taking a gap year before heading off to university. Niza Chifunda, who joined us October 2017, she's planning on going to the UK. She wants to study business economics and finance. Alinani Membe, our August 2017 joiner. He's studying biomedical research and he's going to Canada. Julia Atkins, 2015, in December, she's going back to the Netherlands and she's going to study marketing management. Wenya Chikoti, September 2015, she's off to the UK. She doesn't quite know quite which university yet, but she wants to study business management. Teresa Nell, who joined us also in April 2015, she's going to South Africa and she's going to study biokinetics. And Elizabeth Hoskins, joined in February 2015. She's hoping to go to do study psychology at Durham University, and that's in the UK.
And we move on now to our next graduate. As you can see, Chisha joined us in August 2011. If you have a look at the images there, one thing that's been common throughout is that big, broad smile, and we know he's going to take that with him. He's off to the UK. He's undecided yet as to whether it'll be at the University of Glasgow or the University of Manchester, but Chisha intends to go on and study computer science, and we wish him the very best of luck there. Next, we have Tabea. Tabea has also been with us since August 2011. We've got a number of photos in here. This last year, she's been our head girl. Tabea is going on to study in university, I think it's Thurgau in her home country of Switzerland. And she's going to be studying secondary education. And perhaps in years to come, Tabea may even find her way back to Baobab to work. We'll have to wait and see if that then happens. But we wish her the best as she goes on to her studies. Joining them ever so slightly before that, in July of 2011, was Leando. And again, we've got some images of her throughout her time here with us. Leando is also going off to the UK and going to the University of Manchester, and she's also going to be studying computer science. Perhaps her and Chisha will end up in the same class next year. Wouldn't that be interesting? And we wish her the very best of luck as she goes on to there. Next, we have Andrew. Andrew joined us slightly earlier than Leandro in June 2011. Andrew is also going off to the UK. He's not yet decided which university he will be joining, but he will be going off to study sports science in the UK. Next up, we have Lusamaker. We've just spoken about how he's completed his 10 years of service here at Baobab. Lusamaker has been our head boy this academic year. He's always been very studious. Have a look at the photo on the top left from his time down in the primary school. Lusamaker is also going off to the UK. He's going to the University of Leicester. He's going to go and study business and marketing. And perhaps when he's there, he might cross paths with Patson Daka if he goes to watch Leicester play football. But we wish him all the very best of luck there. Next up, we have Zanelli Munjanja. She's been also with us since January 2011. Zanelli has not quite decided where she's going to be going to go and pursue her further studies, but she is fairly decided that she's either going to be doing law or social sciences. Since August 2010, Hetvi has been a Baobab student. And we've got some lovely images of her time throughout here, including an image from her primary school photos from one of them. Hetvi is going to go off to Spain to the EU Business School, where she will be studying business administration. Anna, again, been with us for a very long time, since August 2009. We were able to delve deep and get some very old primary school photos there. Anna is going off to the UK. She's not entirely sure of which university she will be starting at when she starts her degree course next year, but she is certain that it will be in chiropractic and health study. Lara van der Heide came a year earlier than Anna in August 2008. Some images here, including one of her high jumping, one of her strong skills, a bit of a family trait. Lara is not entirely sure where she'll be going. I'm sure it may well be Holland, but she's going to be taking a gap year before she goes on to university. So we will wait the news of where she finally goes in due course. Now we're down to the grandfather of this academic year group, the young man who's been here for the longest, since June 2007, Anish. I tried as hard as I could to find some very old photos, and the best I could do were the ones on the left. I think the ones and the image we possibly will remember Anish most fondly for is his love of chess and his strong prowess in playing chess. Anish is going to be going off to the UK, to the Loughborough University, where he will be studying finance. And we wish Anish all the very best of luck. On to the grandmothers of this group. Keren has been a student here since June 2007. Some lovely images of her time way back in the primary school, including an excerpt from a very old magazine with her heart and a bit of artwork that she did in there. Keren, like a lot of the other students, will be going on to the UK, where she will be studying business management. And finally, the young lady who's been here the longest of all this group, since January 2006. Just do some maths of that. That's a very, very long time. That's 15 and a bit years that Nabila has been a student here. I thought we'd go back to maybe her first contribution of academic work, the poem, or not even the poem, the sentence we've got here, apples are good for your teeth. I wonder if she still eats an apple a day. And we've got a bit of her original artwork, as well as her very first school photo when she was down in ELC. Nabila is not yet entirely sure of where she's going to be going after school, but she's going to be taking a gap year and then she'll be going on to further her studies. And we look forward to finding out where that will be in due course. So let's just have a look at our graduating students today, where they're going off and around the world. We can see very much that it's a global class. They're going to be touching all the corners of the earth. A lot of them will be going off to the UK, but for all of them, we wish them the very best of luck as they move forward.
Now, it's only fitting for these students to have the final say in their own graduation. And many thanks to Mwenya for putting the following video together. And now it's over to our class of 2020-2021, whom we wish the very, very best and thank them for all of their contributions to the school and wish them well in their new endeavours. I'm going to hand over to the students now to have their own say.
My fellow graduates, I know this isn't what we had in mind for our graduation, but I guess we have to make do with whatever situation has been thrown upon us. Actually, if COVID has taught me anything, it's to expect the unexpected and to be prepared for anything. I came to Baobab in the year of 2006, so I was practically birthed in Baobab. I remember my first day, I was so scared and I would not stop crying. And now it's like my last day and I'm crying again. So I guess you could say nothing really has changed. Nah, I'm kidding. If anything, I'm crying because of how important Baobab has become to me. Baobab hasn't only been a beautiful looking school, but it's always been able to maintain its high standards. Baobab is really an experience that I will never ever forget, and it will be one that I will proudly talk about. The amount of memories I've made here have been unreal. I'll never forget the day I was thrown into the baby pool with armbands because I was too scared to go in myself. By the way, I'm still traumatized by that, and I'm reminded of it every single time I look at a swimming pool. I'll never forget the fun times my friends and I had playing on the swings and the tires in the playgrounds. The way the boys' voices changed from squeaky chipmunks to Dwayne The Rock Johnson sounding people who now think they can take on the world. Or the way the girls' interest shifted from Barbie dolls to doing hair and makeup. I still remember how people would go crazy over the science lessons we had when learning about the human body. If you know, you know. Or the French lesson where someone said je suis toilette, which translates into I am toilet. I remember how they used to threaten us in detentions about how they were going to make us scrape all the gum from underneath all the tables. It really made me try not to get detentions, which didn't really work out though in the end. I'll never forget wanting to kick a ball at the referees in the football games, who always seemed biased towards other teams. Or the time I scored a goal from the halfway line, or took an amazing corner that Monia scored with her pretty head. In short, all of these memories have played a part in making me who I am today, which, let's be honest, is an amazing person. However, now it's time to move forward and take on new journeys in life. Don't get me wrong, I would love to relive these memories, but it's time for the next chapter in our lives, away from Baobab, as hard as that may be. My fellow graduates, I believe in each and every one of you, and I believe that we can take on whatever life will throw at us now. I would like to thank everyone that influenced my life in one way or the other. My teachers, who educated me on different aspects in life. My friends, who lifted me when I didn't have the courage to get up myself. And my family, for loving and supporting me through anything and everything. I would like to thank Baobab for providing us with a safe environment to learn in and for instilling confidence in me that I never ever had before. I wish everyone the best, and I wish for nothing but success for you guys. Thank you, stay safe, and remember, you'll never walk alone.
Hello parents, teachers, friends and family. It is truly a joyous occasion that is before us, the graduation of the class of 2021. Today marks a special day in our lives, the day we take flight and soar into our own separate journeys, each leading us to different destinations. I want to start off by saying congratulations. Congratulations to the students for pedaling through the 15-year marathon. Congratulations to teachers for pushing and motivating us through this journey. We have finally reached the finish line. It has been a roller coaster ride with twists and turns, but now we are finally here. Personally, my journey at Baobab is something I'll always treasure. The memories and experiences we had as a class are something that I always hold dearly. We have watched each other grow from weakness to strength, from failure into success. It is now time to hone our skills and knowledge and truly become the future. I can proudly say that Baobab is my second home. On a final note, I would like to say thank you to our parents for the unconditional support and guidance that we receive. The beginning of our journey is now.
Perfect disasters. We were reaching, reaching for the rafters. And on most of the days we were searching for ways to get up and get out of the town we were raised, yeah, cause we were done. I remember we were sleeping in cars, we were searching for ours, we were burning cigars with the white plastic tips till we saw the sun. So crazy things like I refuse to look back thinking days were better just because of younger days. I don't know what's round the corner where I feel right now. I swear we'll never change. Back when we were kids, swore we would never die. You and me were kids.
saying things like, I used to look back thinking days were better just because of younger days. I don't know what's round the corner, where I feel right now, I swear I've never changed. Back when we were kids, swore we would never die. You and me were kids, swore that we'll never die. Nights when we kept dancing, changing all our plans, making every day a holiday. Feel the east start burning, city lights that turning, but something about this feels the same.
And that brings us to the end of our proceedings this morning. To all of our award winners, I would like to extend hearty congratulations to our Year 12s. We look forward to seeing you back in school in August, ready to start the second year of your A-level courses. And to our Year 13s, we wish you bon voyage and all the very best as you go on to your university courses. And please do stay in touch with us. We would love to hear of your progress. Have a great break, everybody.